guys, day 10 of JuV. I've been wanting to make this video for quite some time, and I thought, why not? So a lot of people remember the X-Men animated TV show from the 90s, and then, you know, we don't hear a lot about a lot of the other Marvel X-Men TV shows, animated shows, for quite some time. They've not had that many other ones, and it's mostly just the 90s one that gets a lot of critical acclaim. What a lot of people don't remember is X-Men Evolution, and there's not very much footage on YouTube of it. Yeah, I just wanted to talk about it because it's one of the most fond memories I have of a Marvel TV show. I really enjoyed that show, and it just works really well, and I wanted to talk about it. X-Men Evolution does the same sort of things that a lot of Marvel X-Men TV shows do, and that, you know, the X-Men are a thing, and they go about and are superhero-y and fight for mutant rights and stuff. Now, what X-Men Evolution does differently is that while most of them have maybe a single kid appeal character that's like Kitty Pryde or Jubilee, and that's about it, X-Men Evolution has basically all of its main X-Men being kid appeal characters, because they're all teenagers. This X-Men Evolution brings them back to the point where the X-Men are a school. The X-Men are a school, and they are, in fact, all teenagers apart from Professor X, obviously. Wolverine makes sense to do if you want to actually have his character background right, and Storm, which, okay, that one works as well. The main X-Men team in the show are Professor X, Wolverine, and Storm, obviously, Cyclops, Jean Grey, Nightcrawler, Shadowcat, Spike, a new character original created for this show, and Rogue. And those nine are the main core cast. Most of the first season is just the X-Men competing with the Brotherhood of Mutants, who are led by Mystique and Magneto, and who are just trying to find other mutants to join either side. And so we get the Brotherhood, or another set of interesting characters, and they get some of their own character development. And then in season two, there's a bunch of new students get introduced who are basically the new mutants. Their film is coming out next year, but doesn't look that great, but we'll see how it is. And there's just a bunch of really interesting, well-plotted arcs for each character, and each set of characters have their own development and arcs, and just, it's a good show. The show's also got really strong continuity. Every bit is well-placed in the way that the story fits together. There's four seasons, and each of them flows fairly naturally on from the last, and just works to give us what the show is telling us, if that makes sense. Each character has a good couple of character development episodes where they just are showcased really well, and it's great. It's really good, and yeah, it's a top-notch show. I really wanted to use footage from it in this video, but I don't have access to it at the moment, and as I said, there's none on YouTube. So I recommend that you try and find out where you can watch X-Men Evolution. It's a really good show. Go check it out. And let me know what you think in the comments down below, because I'd love to know. Down there. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and that you remember to like and share it, and subscribe to my channel. Click on the thumbnails down below to see other videos by me, and I will see you guys tomorrow for the next day of JuV. Bye!